So now that we have the dough part of our donut, let's talk a bit about the glazing, or the icing, that is. To create my icing, I want to select the upper parts of the donut here. So let's work on this stream here and use that to create the icing. However, I want to get rid of this weight attribute here. Let's use an attribute delete to delete the weight attribute that's on our points, like so, and we can't see it anymore. Next, let's just select this upper parts of our donut using a group node again, this time set to primitives. So we will select polygons here, and we're going to disable the base group and check keep by normals, which allows me to select faces, that is polygons of my model, by their angle towards a normal, towards a vector. And the direction I mainly want to select is the up direction. And Houdini uses a Y-app axis system. So let's create a 0, 1, 0 vector just pointing upwards, and then dial back the maximum allowed spread angle to just select faces, that means polygons, which are pointing in this direction, plus some given angle. Let's set this to 45 degrees. And thinking about this, for the steps I'm going to perform, I'd rather select points over primitives like this. And this is a bit uniform, don't you think? Icing would typically not look that uniform. So let's apply a little hack here. And as we are selecting those points here, depending on their normals angle towards another vector, let's just randomize the normal angle a bit and thus randomize the selection. We're going to use an attribute noise for that and wire it in before the group. And we don't want to randomize our color diffuse, which looks like this and a bit funny and a bit like a 90s painting, but we want to randomize N, our normal. And also let's switch the mode to multiplicative, not additive. So what this did is in the selection, it randomize the selection a bit, but also when we just highlight this here and bypass this node. So if you click here on a node, you can just deactivate it, disable it. You can see by randomizing our normals, also the geometry now looks a bit bumped, because what we basically did here is we created a random bump map. So after we selected our points, let's get rid of those weird normals again using another normal node wiring in after the group. And let's set this to generate point normals again. So now we fixed our randomized normals and have standard normals again. All this just to select a few points here, those, and we're going to create another weight attribute on those points, again using the trusty attrib create that we already know, highlighting this. Again, on the points, we're going to create a weight, which is going to be 0 everywhere but 1 for the group we just created. That is group 2. Again, sloppy naming here. Let's take this visualize node and hook it up down here, highlight it. So that's the weight attribute we just created. And as previously, it's a bit harsh here. So let's blur it out again using an attrib blur. It goes in here. Attrib I want to blur is called weight. And in this case, let's maybe blur it out 8 iterations, like so. Now, this whole thing looks a bit smoother, but glazing would not fade out like that usually. So I want some way to kind of remap those values here. And yes, you might have guessed, the node that does that is called attribute remap. We'll have that in here. Set the original name of the attribute you want to remap to weight. And let's use this slider here to adjust how contrasty the edge of this attribute here should be. Let's drag this down, maybe like that. So how do we turn this weighted selection here into our icing? Well, in this case, what I want to do is scatter points on where the weight is high, and then use those points to fuse them together to form a volume, which looks like the blobby liquid that icing is, and then mesh that back into a polygonal mesh. Let's do that by dropping down a scatter node, which is one of the most powerful and most used nodes in Houdini usually. It's there to scatter points on the surface. In this case, I want to use a density attribute, which we called weight. Not density. So now you can see we are only scattering the points in the areas where our weight attribute is high. Want to scatter a few more points, let's say 32,000, like this. And when I drag this down here, you can see we've got a tab with relaxed iterations. And this tab is there to remove point intersections and scatter those points more uniformly. So when I disable this, you can see my point distribution is really, really random. And as soon as I enable this and maybe increase my relaxed iterations to, say, in this case, 32, you can see we're getting a really, really uniform point distribution. Let's go with this and just ghost the underlying torus that we're working from by clicking on this flag here on the node, which will display the underlying geometry. The glazing does not really intersect with our donut, but is just on top of it. So let's move those points away from the donut surface a bit using what's called a peak node, which just moves those points along its normal direction. So we dial this up here, you can see those points move away from the donut's surface. And in my previous tests, a value of 0.02 seemed to do nicely. All right, let's turn those individual points into a volume using a node that's called VDB from particles, as those points are basically particles. Particles and points in Houdini are the same thing. So wiring in this into our VDB from particles and highlighting it. And this definitely is a bit too coarse and too big. So let's dial back the point radius scale first. That is the overall scale of our individual particles here. Let's dial it back to a really, really small size of 0.03 units. And now all my particles are gone. That is because my voxel size has to be at least as small as this, usually half of this size here. Let's just add in a zero here like this. And there we have our surface here. And you might rightfully say that this does not really look like glazing or any liquid. And I totally totally agree. So let's go about shaping this. And the first thing I want to do is randomize each of those individual particles, give them their individual scale using an attrib noise, which we're going to wire in here. And we will create and also randomize an attribute called P scale. So that's an intrinsic Houdini attribute, and it's short for particle scale. You can see that already did something. Let's drag this down here and check remap noise and enter 0.8 as our minimum size and maybe 1.3 as our maximum size. So what that did is it just gave a slight variation in our individual particle scale. Let's drag this down here a bit and maybe decrease our element size. That means our noise will get a higher frequency. We'll just scale our noise down like so. All right. Next, you can see those particles around the edges here, they are not as densely scattered as up here. And also, when we look at icing, the icing should be thicker around these areas as the drops form there. Also, when you just have a look at those individual points here that form the underlying particles and middle mouse and hold on this node here, we can see which attributes we currently have on those points. We have a normal, a position, a P scale, the particle scale, and the weight. So when we scattered the points onto this donut shape here, this weight attribute also got transferred to our points. And you can see in those areas where the points are far apart and should be a bit bigger, the weight attribute is smaller. So let's use that to our advantage and use an attribute remap to actually remap our weight to our P scale. Let's wire this in before our P scale, highlight our VDB from particles, and for now, let's disable our attribute noise here. And in the attribute remap, let's remap our weight to our P scale. And let's drag this down and use this ramp here to remap our values from something rather big. Let's also drag down this ramp here. So rather big value at the beginning. So these are those particles here, then going down in size, staying there a bit maybe. And then in these areas up here on top, the particle size can get bigger again. Let's just select all of these controls by clicking on this control here, holding down shift, clicking on this control, then scrolling down here and setting the interpolation to be a B-spline. So we get a smoother curve here. Next, let's re-enable our attrib noise here, the P scale. And instead of adding this value here, I want to set the mode to multiplicative. So we are multiplying the P scale values we created with this attrib remap with those values from the noise here. And we can see we are getting some loose parts here, which we could fix by increasing our minimum and maybe also our maximum value here. Let's leave them like that for now and fix the fact that this looks like a bunch of individual spheres by reshaping our actual volume using a reshape SDF node here, which we're going to attach after our VDB from particles. And we're going to highlight it, and automatically it's set up to dilate. That means to enlarge in our volume here. We can dial in the offset, making this arbitrarily big. But for now, I just want to dilate this one voxel. Next, let's smooth this out. So we're getting rid of those spherical artifacts here by using a VDB smooth. And as this is a signed distance field, which is used to store geometry in contrast to store, for example, smoke or a fog, we're going to use the smooth SDF, smooth signed distance field. Highlight this. You can now see we smoothed out some of those areas. However, let's increase the iterations a bit here and smooth this out further. And now it's time to adjust the P scale, I think. So let's increase our minimum and maximum scale. Let's go back to our attrib remap, where we remapped these individual thicknesses here. And I think I want to make the contrast between those edges and those parts here a bit stronger. So let's maybe add another control point here. And I'll just kind of drag this down and move this over here, maybe. Maybe something like this. So down here, after we smoothed this, I think this is a bit thick for our icing now. So let's use a reshape SDF node again, and this time set this to erode to take away a bit of its thickness. And let's see. Yeah, I think an offset of one voxel is enough for now. So let's convert this back into a mesh using a convert VDB set to polygons. So now we created this polygonal mesh out of our volume. If this mesh is a bit too high res for your taste, you can adjust the adaptivity here, where Houdini tries to automatically reduce the poly count of said mesh. However, in this case, I think I'll just leave it at this in order to preserve detail and not having to worry too much about messy topology. One neat trick to smooth out those meshes that you generated with volumes is to attach a normal and another attribute blur, setting the normal to point normals and then the attribute blur to blur out our P, that is our position, as well as our N, our normal attribute, and then maybe setting this to 4 blurring iterations. So just to smooth out this mesh a bit further. So that would be my setup for the glazing. Let's zoom out here a bit. And you can see our node tree starts to get a bit more complicated. Let's clean it up a bit by just selecting all of these nodes, holding down A, and then this cursor appears, and I'm just gonna hold my mouse, and I'm just gonna press and hold my left mouse button and draw a line like this. And now these nodes have been automatically layouted and set to uniform spacing. Let's do the same thing for this and this part of the tree. Let's attach a few nulls here just to make this a bit more readable and just color these nulls, maybe a bright green like this. By the way, I brought up the color palette pressing C over the node view here for color. Let's copy this and paste it. Command C, Command V. Attach this one below our attrib blur here. Call this one icing. or rather out underscore icing. Call this one here out underscore dough, and this will be attached to our subdivide up here where the dough resides. Let's merge those two geometry streams, the one with the icing and the one with the dough, using a merge node. Let's wire in the dough first and then the icing and highlight this. And you can see the icing is black. That is because we have no point color set on this icing. So let's do that just for now using another color node. Wire this in maybe before the null here and set this color to whatever you want your icing to be. Maybe something like that. Now, if you say this is too much icing, what you can do is go up here where we selected the initial points that make up this icing group and just dial back our spread angle here, and the whole setup will procedurally follow and enlarge in or shrink in the area in which the icing is applied. Or maybe you want more icing. I don't know. Whatever floats your boat or your donut. Now, that was quite a tour de force. However, I hope you've got an idea how we are able to build more complex effects inside of Houdini just using a bunch of very, very basic operators that we string together to form this chain here. And what this needs now is sprinkles, and we're going to tackle those in the next tutorial. And if you like what we're doing and want to support us or maybe get access to more in-depth tutorials, you might want to head over to our Patreon and consider becoming a patron of ours. And to all of you guys already supporting us, thanks so much. All of this would not be possible without you. With a very, very special thank you going out to Gearbox Studios Quebec, Important Looking Pirates, Chris Hebert, and Rafik Anadol. Thanks so much, guys.